Hello, my name's Perry Dolling. I work for the Department of Primary Industries and Regional Development based at Katanning. So we're here today to talk about measuring pasture and measuring pasture quantity. An alternative word for measuring the pasture quantity we use is called food on offer, or FOO for short. Now, some of the reasons why we want to measure pasture production, pasture quantity, is firstly to match the animal requirements with the supply of energy from the pasture. Secondly, to more precisely get the supplementary feeding right. And thirdly, feed planning. And a component of feed planning is what the current food on offer is. Another component of that is also stocking rate and the pasture growth rates. So in terms of assessing the food on offer for a paddock, we've got a guide and we've published photos of varying levels of pasture production. Now, this guide is broken into three seasons, so at the break of the season, midwinter and into spring. It's also broken up into different pasture types. And so we have a grass pasture, a legume-based pasture, and also a mixed pasture. So a second way to assess the food on offer is to do pasture cuts, and it's a much more accurate way than comparing it to photos. And so first thing to do with this technique is to assess the variability within the paddock. And what you're after is a range in food on offer levels. We're trying to aim to get around three spots, so one with a low food on offer and a high food on offer and one in the middle. Then we're going to do some pasture cuts on those areas. So in terms of determining the food on offer, it's mainly driven by the density of plants and also the height of the plants. And so with these quadrats areas that we've pegged out, you need to run your hands through just to get a feel for that density and the height of the pasture. So these areas are your calibration cuts, and you need to remember how much FOO is in them. So it's best to either peg out an adjacent area with the equivalent or same food on offer for each of the quadrats, or alternatively take a photo of those spots and so that you can remember how much food there is. The next step is to cut the pasture. In terms of food on offer, it's about cutting it to ground level. So once you've cut, the next step is to weigh the pasture. And once we've weighed the pasture, I use a ready reckoner to convert it to dry matter terms. And so we want to convert it to dry matter because water has no energy content. Now, at the start of the season, as a rule of thumb, you're looking at around 90% water. But as we go into the season, then the water content decreases to around 80%. And then as you get into spring, you're looking at around 70% water. Once we've cut the three areas and you've had a good look at the areas, you can consider yourself calibrated. And so the next step is then to go across the paddock and in random spots, estimate the food on offer. Now, if the paddock is particularly even, I aim for around 15 estimates of the food on offer. But if it is quite variable, then you've got to increase that number perhaps up to around 20. So the second point in terms of getting accurate food on offer is around pasture composition or species. Now, some species are less palatable to the animal than others. At the start of the growing season, they're more or less all the species are the same, and so there's no differences. But as the season progresses, pasture species such as capeweed become less palatable to the animal, and so they'll leave it. So again, when you're walking across the paddock, make an assessment of the composition so you can adjust those figures if there's a lot of capeweed, big large capeweed in the paddock. The last point I wanted to make is that the calibration that you've done is very suitable for other paddocks, so long as the composition is the same. And also, you can use that same calibration into the future as well. So that wraps up how to measure food on offer for a paddock. And in another video, we'll show how to use those food on offer figures to feed budget.